Hello, Internet. James Allen from Out of 8, and today I'm playing Space Station Management Simulation Rym Capsule. In the game, you place rooms that your minions will produce resources and defend against an alien invasion. There's three different game modes. There is the normal mode, which was also available on mobile devices. There's also a plus mode, which offers a slightly different map and different bonuses, and a zen mode that has no enemies. I'm going to choose the plus mode and just start a new game. So you start out with a couple minions and basically an empty space station. So what you do is you basically place rooms and then they will go and construct it for you. So I'm going to start with the corridor, drag them both over to construction, and then you can place other rooms. There's an extractor like this, which will extract this little pink stuff. There's three different resources you can see pictured down here. A reactor makes the blue stuff. The gardens and the kitchen working together makes food. Your weapons will defend against the alien invasion, and then quarters will house two additional minions. You can also see that the rooms have these little Tetris piece shapes, so there's a little bit of kind of a mini game into placing these in the most efficient manner and being able to access the different things. These little monoliths out here will give you a bonus, like for this one. Makes any of the resources last forever. The pink stuff is really the limiting resource of the game because the reactors and the gardens and kitchen basically last forever. So let those guys build that. I actually need a weapon thing here. Place that right there. You don't want to queue up too much stuff because they won't necessarily build in the order you place things. They'll kind of pick whatever they grab the resources for, so you can definitely get yourself in a bit of trouble by choosing the wrong thing to build, and then they'll split themselves out over like two or three different rooms at one time, like they're doing right now. You know, they're building two separate things for whatever reason. So, and that's basically it. So you spend your time placing rooms, giving them a task, and there'll be more tasks that come about as I construct more rooms here. And that's basically it. And you can just kind of survive for as long as you can against the enemy waves that will come over. If you place a guy in the engineering, they'll produce the little blue stuff faster. Isn't really necessary most of the time. And I need to start getting a kitchen going here. So I'll get my garden and a kitchen. There. And then another corridor over towards this monolith. There's my defense. So you can put two guys in there and then they'll shoot any enemies that income. Defensive rooms have a certain range, as you can see here with this blue area right there. The game's pace starts out very slow, as you'll see. And then it kind of quickens as the waves become faster and faster and more powerful as the game progresses onward. So basically, kind of the early game is just trying not to crash your economy as best you can. So you can see again the minions kind of split their tasks up. Now you can prioritize rooms, which does help a little bit in producing things, but you don't really want to queue anything more than like two or three things at a time. So they'll just kind of get confused and lost and run out of resources. So there's my garden. And then they'll work on my kitchen next. And then I can start moving on to do another quarter so I can get some more minions going. Pull that down now. I think I'll fit it right there. Then I can put another extractor over by this pink stuff. And let me see how I can connect to that. I kind of have to go up and around. So we can do a box. So after this goes, I'm going to prioritize the quarter house. Oh, this little red timer shows when the enemies will come. So you kind of have a little bit of a warning as to when you need to move your guys into defense. When you start out, you're going to have to swap people back and forth. But once you get a really large kind of station going, then you can keep people in defense all the time and not have to move them back and forth. The enemies will come in and try to shoot people, so you'll have to replace them, you know, using the quarter management and stuff like that. So here goes my food, so I can put somebody in food service, which I will need to do once my quarter thing gets completed. Let's see what the other bonuses are. That one, quicker. Construct next 4 rooms. I'm going for 6 minions. It's kind of the one I'm going to go for. That one and this other one are pretty good. This will give you basically indefinite resources. So, the game is certainly a very relaxed pace as you wait for things to construct. You know, I'm not really doing anything now. I'm just waiting for them to get that quarters room open. I'm going to have to pull them over to defense here in a little bit. Yeah, there we go. There you go. Go shoot some guys for me, please. You can finish that room when you're done. Here they come. So you can see very stylized graphics, which actually are pretty effective, to be quite honest. Pretty slick looking. There's some scouts. Pew pew. There we go, good job. Alright, back to construction. Kind of wait for this to pull up, and then I'll pull one of the construction guys over to food service. I should probably do that the next time they bring in some, because I need food service anyway. Yeah, you don't know where you're going to take that, do you? Alright, go to food. Because I'm out of food. So that's what I mean, you got to kind of keep an eye on your economy. Especially in the beginning of the game. I could also probably pull a guy over to do engineering if I really needed that blue stuff. But he's really just waiting for food to spawn, which goes quickly enough. I think one more. Yeah, he's just waiting. When they fall over on their side, they're idle. So I like that it does it on the map and also on the bottom. You know, the interface... There we go. Is kind of, you can tell it's designed for mobile platforms first, because you can't just click and place, you have to drag it down like that, which is kind of annoying using a mouse. Same thing over here, you can't just click, you just drag it, you know, like you would with your finger. So that's just, you know, one thing to kind of get used to. You can click and select things, but then you still have to drag it down to place the order. Yeah, there we go. I'm going to put you in food service, too. Get some more minions. Alright, so now I can start moving on, I think. I should probably put one of these guys over in engineering to get some more blues. So let's pull my corridor. I'm going to try to corridor up over here. I'm actually getting really lucky. Hey, get out of the way. I got a box, so actually this should be okay. Ah, crud. Alright, I gotta think about this. I don't know. You gotta think about placement there to make sure I hit that right, so there isn't much room. Alright, go construct stuff. You too. Alright, so what do I need? Basically expand here. An extractor should be going. Prioritize that just in case. Probably do another quarters here in a second. Oh, they're expensive. And do another defense. There we go. You have a little pile of resources. And you can actually get rid of rooms. Like when you run out of resources, you can actually disassemble the room. So that'll give you some resources back. Alright, engineering's not doing anything. Go back to... what do you need to do? Construction, I guess. Go build stuff. Uh-oh. Alright, we'll see how I do here. Hopefully I haven't spread myself out too much. I need to prioritize that room. Oh. No. Yeah, circle near those guys. There we go. Okay, good. Didn't lose anybody. Got some hits, but... Alright. I will prioritize that other defense thing. I need that, especially because I have four people. And then we'll go on from there. This is actually good for a corridor. There we go. Alright, prioritize this. I need defense. Probably could use another extractor over there too. Or a reactor. Actually. I don't think I need another garden-kitchen combination yet though. Need to get that weapons thing up though first. Go, little minions, go. Yeah, what are you gonna do with that blue thing now? That was poor planning. Yeah, there you go. Let's move one of these guys to food. I will need to build some more food stuff over here. We're gonna just do that. Basically, you're just kind of... I'm just kind of carbon copying my design from over there. Yeah, we can do that. Alright. So that'll be kind of our next thing. I'll just have to keep an eye on them, make sure they're not crashing my economy. You're basically done. Go back to construction. Alright, prioritize. I need more minions. You see, in the beginning, it takes a really long time for the waves to come, but later on, it's like 15, 20 seconds between waves, right before you're about to die, usually. I do need to get that other pink thing. Oh, this is done, isn't it? That was quick. Alright, I'm going to get these other two. I really need to get down here, too. Unfortunately, there's no real reason to build that way. Let's see. Is this what I want? No. No, it is not. Come on, get that thing going. One person of food service. Oh, you got it. Alright, here. Just go to defense. This guy's coming. Oh, what do I want to do? Pretty good on resources. Just kind of need to expand. Probably could use another... I need some more minions and more defense. Another defense thing. Like over in this area. Hello. Actually what I'll use that room for. There we go, perfect fit. Alright, so I'll just pull one to food service. And we'll do the rest in construction. Try to get this other thing up so I can get two more minions. Need to build. Build out this way and get that extractor going. Just gonna focus on this part for right now though. We'll see how far we can survive. Really like to get that. Once you link to it, then you can assign minions to research. So that'll be nice to pull that in. Let's see, which other one do I actually want? That one's pretty good too. God, they're so far away though. See, that one I would like. But gosh, it's such a waste of space going all the way out there. Alright, food service. I don't even know what you guys are building yet. Build that. I need that. Then I need that other reactor built next. Starting to run out of blue stuff. When this new guy gets spawned, I'm probably going to assign him to engineering for now. Hello? Bloop. Engineering, please. Alright, well, you got that going. Almost there with another one. Actually in fairly decent shape. Right here, do this, guys. You go back to construction. Getting close to alarm time here. Yep. All right, go. Everybody, run! Seem to stand a better chance of survival when they're manning a gun, because they can shoot back. Alright, four enemies. All the way to wave four. Ah, shoot. That's why I need two. Alright. We need to spawn some more people here. Once you lose all your minions, then the game's over, so. You have these food service guys get going here. What are you building? Why are you building that? Go here where I prioritized it. That's what I mean. Why would you go that way? Service, please. Need more minions. This is maxed. Yeah, this is not, though. Alright, research. Go. Alright, getting kind of full on the food. Those are all your tasks right there. So, really, it's just a matter of kind of micromanaging them a little bit, making sure that nobody's idle. And we'll see how long I can last. Trying to think where I want to head to. If I even want. And that would be great if I could do that. It's just so far away. That's the problem. It's going to really slow me down. I guess that's what I'm going to do, though. I need this stuff built, though, first. So inefficient. They're building three things at once. Finish something first, please. So I just need to build a corridor down here and put like defense down here to defend, help defend the researchers if they can't get back in time. All right, go. Got six and six. You guys need to hurry. And you're not hurrying, Slowpoke. You're gonna die. Alright, I'm gonna have to do max research because I really want those. Those guys, those six guys, I really put them to use. Alright, yeah. Prioritize this. That would be fantastic. And once that junk's done, then we'll worry about expanding down. These are out of resources, which is unfortunate. I really need to tap these two, and then I'm gonna just beeline down this way. So I'm basically out of pinks, which is not good. Start making some more people. Alright. Yeah, you're going up there, aren't you? Alright, let's do this corridor here. Be able to fit that, not on the next piece, but I can do that as a weapons, and then I'll pull this in. There we go. All right, there's my little extension. Yep, I got somebody idle. Go construct. I'm almost done with this. Food service guy should be idle pretty soon, too. That's tapped. I don't even think I want you guys to do that, to be honest. I'm not gonna really need it once I get these six guys. I'm gonna pull them all in construction. This might be bad timing, though. With the defenses. There we go. Whole bunch of people. Go build. I'm gonna be very sad when I lose all this stuff. So I only have six. Please prioritize that. A whole bunch of people, I hope I take them out. Without them taking me out. Come on. No! Dang it! Come on. Really? Yes, thank you. Goodness gracious. Alright. Everybody go build. I want this stuff now. How many minions do I have? 10 almost? Actually, I might build another thing there. Everybody go build. Let's pull one in engineering. I want this. I need that bonus. Then I can just basically start turtling and just kind of build up and wait. Just spam weapons, man them with enough quarter people. Get rid of these. There we go. Yeah, then I'm just gonna pull a full thing over to research that. Luckily, the quarters are cheap, so they go up real quick. Done. Somebody's got to do food. And this up, and then that up, and then I'm going to build over to this. Should be okay after I get this basic plan done. I really need that built before they come, and it's not going to happen. Alright, get out of here. Wish there was kind of a select all button to kind of send everybody over. Alright, we'll see how I do here. Perfect. Except for that guy. Dummy. Jerk. Alright, go. There we go. So, max research. Food service to bring my pot back up. Although, I can't actually, because that was the bonus, so I can't actually recover those people. Through. Yeah, because those are maximum. I do need this. So I actually don't need food service too much. Need that built as soon as this is done. There we go. Alright, you don't have a choice. You gotta build that, and then I'm gonna just do this. And that's gonna basically be it. Yeah, perfect. Alright. Then I'm just gonna kinda go from there. Yeah, once this is researched, I don't even want these guys down on this side. To be honest. I'll just kinda keep everybody up in this, up in the range of weapons. What are we at? 46. I don't think they're gonna make it before the aliens come. Fifteen. But as soon as they research this, then that'll be taken care of, and I got plenty of this too. So I can just start building my pop. Alright, very good. Well, I really don't have anything for you guys to do, so just send you straight to defense. And get ready. Yep. Alright, go. Alright, while this is going on, I'll plan what I want to do next. Should be a quarters down here. Basically, you're just going to do quarters and weapons. The more people you have, the longer you can survive, so that's what I'm going to do. Get him. Okay. Let's get these rooms up. Or this room up, at least. Oh, where else should I go? Up here, I guess. Prioritize that, it's closer. Actually, no, prioritize that. Everybody's delivering stuff there. Eight. So I'm actually balanced right now. Actually, a little bit over for defense. This is almost done though. I'm actually thinking about just selling this. TBH. Yeah. Well, I'm not even gonna worry about it. Because there should be no reason they go down to this part of the map anymore after I research this. I'm just going to keep everybody up here. Hopefully. Alright, excellent. Alright, just go build. You don't even need that stuff. Alright, we'll do one food service, one in engineering, although I don't even need it. Get these things up. Just a matter of time. I'd also use put one down here. Actually. So that one's prioritized, but we'll see. I think you could disconnect this. No, you can't disconnect corridors, but I guess that's a silly question, but I've never tried to disconnect a corridor before. I guess you can, so. There we go. Run. Pretty good setup. All right, back to building. Yep, I can do food service. Yes, I can. We'll see how far we can get. Down. I'm just gonna let him finish these off here. Oh, why would you build over there? Where are you even going? What are you doing? Yeah, that's already done. You're dumb. Go away. Seriously. Let's pull a food service. Get these people going. I gotta think about how many people I have. I need to build another weapons thing. There we go. After you're done with that, that's next priority. Come on. Here we go. About time to pull these people out. Yep. It. So I have two extra, which is why I need that extra room there. It's basically each room gives you two, and then a defense gives you two, so you have to balance them out. 10 enemies. You guys are really slow. Ugh. Got obliterated. I suck. Terrible. Terrible. Gotta be a little bit quicker on the trigger, I think. (Clears throat) about switching them. Make sure they get in the defenses faster. Eventually what happens is you just can't replace your troops fast enough. The waves come too fast. So that's kind of the tipping point. And then you just, all your people get obliterated. Defense is up. So let's see, I have five, but just start with one, so I need another weapons area. And over here. There we go. Do this first, though. No, actually, I should do that first. Should build weapons first. Go build that faster, please. Problem is, the pink things are way on the other side. Gotta expand over in this area more. Next. Not a very efficient design, but it is what it is. Now you just go straight to defense. Yeah, I know what's happening. Everybody run! Run! Faster! Oof. Here they come. I got pretty lucky with this one. Perfect. Alright, go. Got a lot of area here that can expand. Just need to get that done. Where else can I go that's covered? Not really anywhere. Just need to go over here. 6 and 5. So I do another defense and then I'm quarters over on that side after that's done. No, priority this. Not this room. I don't need that. Oh, you guys are stupid. Go over here. Oh, you're not listening to me. This is why you don't queue up more than one thing at a time. Oh my gosh. They are completely ignoring that. Goodness gracious. Alright, I'm gonna pull them now. I actually have 10 and 10, so that matches out pretty well. I just need to haul butt back to their places. That's the problem. Oh, that guy's gonna get blasted. Actually, you finish this room. He'll probably just go try to finish that room and get shot. 12 enemies. Yeah, he's gonna die. Well, maybe not. No, maybe not. Oh, good job. Again, it'd be way more efficient if there was like a, you could right click and like send more than one unit at a time. It's kind of tedious to drag them, especially when you start getting a really big, you know, area going. You see the pace is definitely starting to pick up. Alright, so you guys are going to build that, which will give me 6 and 6 again. Alright, everybody go food service while I think. How many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11... I'm gonna have, yeah, I think I need to do one more weapons thing over here. Then honestly, I might just kind of sit idle. Because there's no real reason to expand any further, to be honest, other than just having more people. That's really kind of it. Alright, start making these people, and then everybody's got to go back to defense. And that's it. So I need, yeah, I need that defensive room. That'll balance it out. I think he just like built it and then got attacked. All right. Do another one. And then I'm actually gonna kinda let him do that and leave him alone. These guys, these constructions are idle. Alright. Should have done this earlier. Got lulled into a false sense of security here. More enemies! There we go. Alright, I'm not actually even building anything. I do need some food service, though. Let's pull everybody into that. Everybody. That was very inefficient, guys. Good job. I actually kind of like my design now. I think I'm going to try to stick with this and see how long I can last with it. It's getting to the point now where I'm not even going to really be able to do anything in between waves. Yeah, that's it. All right. So actually, yeah, actually I'm short too. I can actually build another quarters here. Let's see where I want to place this. Probably over here, yeah. There we go. So I can afford another two guys. So I have two empty spots. Actually, I have more than that. Actually, I have three. Oh, no, I have two. Okay, there he is. Yeah, so basically after each wave, you just pull everybody, you know, I'm gonna start dying here. Pull everybody into food service to respawn people. And then I'm gonna do some construction, get this last one up, although actually that's not a very big priority, to be honest. Now it's gonna start killing me. I'm gonna die soon. Basically, it's just racing to replace people in between the waves. I don't even think I'm gonna need this. I don't think I can grow. Honestly, I don't think I can grow people fast enough where it's gonna even matter. See if I can make, kind of pull these in. I should probably get rid of this. Yeah, here they come again. Go, go, go. See, I got plenty of spots for them. Sixteen enemies. I'm gonna lose like half my guys. Yeah, we're screwed. Yeah, I lost. I lost like half of the people, so now I'm gonna scramble food service here and then. And then have to send them back. So, while this game is kind of devolving here, you know, the game is very relaxed. It doesn't really have much replay value because there's only two maps, and you'll inevitably find the same fate. You just reach a point, as happened a couple ways ago, where you won't be able to replace all the people you lose, no matter how good your design is. That said, there are some interesting aspects of the game. I like the little mini game that it plays with the room placement looking like the Tetris pieces. It has fairly simple resource management, but still gives you some room for messing things up. The little upgrades are nice. The fact that the minions are automated obviously cuts down on micromanagement, but makes it so that they sometimes do things you don't want them to do, especially if you place more than one room at a time. So, you know, it's a decent management game. I don't think it's anything I'm going to play long term, because once you've played it a couple times through, you've kind of seen everything that there is to see, especially with only two maps. I think it'd be more interesting if there were more randomized maps that were included in it. Here comes 17 enemies. Let's see how many people survive this. My guess is not a lot. Yeah. Alright. All we're doing is food service. Alright. Let's start getting rid of some of these rooms here. Yeah. All these ones that are super far away, it's not even gonna matter. I can support 10 with the defenses I have currently. I'm losing about half of them every time, so. I think that's about it. I'm just gonna kinda hang with the structure I have right now. Food service rooms could have been more centrally located, but that's what happens sometimes. Yeah, shoot, I totally forgot. Spacing out again. You guys are gonna die. Even worse than usual. Yeah, go, go, defense. Go. Stop standing around. Go shoot something. Yeah, we're screwed. Especially the guys are still walking around. Two guys left. Can they survive, folks?
He's got one more.
Alright, we're making it one more wave. That's it. So, wave 18 will be the last wave I'll be able to fend off here. Definitely. So, you know, the game, you know, if you're into this sort of type of game, it's definitely unique in its presentation. Has a nice little simplicity to it. You can kind of tell that it was kind of designed with mobile devices in mind, although the pace is really slow to begin with. You know, a single game takes about an hour start to finish, which seems kind of long for a mobile device. You know, that things they usually strive on instant gratification, as it were. But, you know, I haven't had any problems with the PC port, so that's nice. There, yeah, you guys need to get out. I think I'm just gonna die here, I would imagine. I grew, like, what, one guy? No, two guys? That round? I guess to the point where it's just not even worth taking them out of defense. And they're just gonna get obliterated here. Yep, there we go. 59 minutes. Almost an hour. So there you go, that's Rymd Capsule, and that's all I have for today. Till next time, bye now.